parents are fighting against President Biden and his, quote, woke policies as the left loses major gubernatorial and school board elections across the country.
We are in charge of parenting our children, not the progressive radicals that are trying to indoctrinate them.
Young can win this campaign because he focused on parents and education.
There are so many parents in Virginia and across the country that are just waking up with a big smile on their face. This was a referendum on parents.
Here to react, biotech entrepreneur and author of Woke Inc. and also a parent, Vivek Ramaswamy. Vivek, is your book working?
Look, I hope it is. I mean, look, I think one of the biggest medicines here is transparency. And as parents began to see what toxicity was being fed to their children, they revolted in a good way for the American system and for our next generation. But I will also tell you, Todd, this is just the beginning of a battlefront that needs to be waged not just in our schools, but in our other institutions across corporate America. And still, I think the work isn't done in schools yet. But I hope it is an indicator, a harbinger of what's to come.
Yeah, well, President Biden he's underwater in almost all the polls, I think all the polls now. And a recent NBC News poll found that 70% of people feel like the country is going in the wrong direction. So what should the administration do about that to fix it?
Look, I think the Democratic Party is at a fork in the road. They're going to have to make a choice as to whether they go back to arguing about economic issues like they used to talk about back in the 1990s and the early 2000s. Or are they going to double down on identity politics, obsessing over race, gender, and sexual orientation? I fear they're going to go the latter direction. For the country, it'd be a lot better if they went the former direction. But here's the issue. Once their policies continue to fail the very people they're supposed to help, that's part of why it becomes beneficial for them to blow woke smoke to be able to cover up accountability for their actual failed policies. So that's the catch-22 for the Democratic Party. Now, I think that what we're going to see in the near term is actually an administration that fails to learn from this mistake, that continues to double down, maybe even talk about why Terry McAuliffe was the wrong candidate because, say, he's a straight white man. I think that's actually going to be the direction that we see them go in the short run. But I don't think that's going to be good for the country because at the end of the day, that sets too low of a bar for Republicans to say that that's going to be an easy administration to defeat. I think that for the country, I'd like to see them actually go in the other direction and elevate our political discourse.
Vivek, you alluded to this in your first answer. How do Republicans maintain the momentum, the anti-woke momentum up until the midterms? Because that's a long time.
Yeah, look, I think the Republican Party had a nice win across the board last night or a couple nights ago. But I think that Republicans need to do better than just criticizing Biden or just criticizing the hypocrisy of the Democrats. That is too easy. That sets too low of a bar. What Republicans actually need to do is be very clear about what the new conservative movement actually stands for. Graduate beyond just talking about what we don't want to see taught in our schools and talk more about what we do want to see taught in our schools. Talk about affirmative civic education in our schools. Talk about reviving a vision of shared American identity that dilutes this woke agenda to irrelevance. Mm. That's going to be harder to do than just pointing out Democratic hypocrisy, but pointing out the hypocrisy of Democrats is too easy. It is not going to be sufficient. It might have been sufficient because the Biden administration is performing so poorly to win one wave of elections in 2021, but going forward for the American people, what the people really need is an affirmative vision of American identity that I think we've been missing for a long time.
There is a business that a lot of parents are familiar with. It's called KinderCare. It's based in Portland, and they're encouraging parents to teach children as young as 6 weeks old equity training. And they released a statement saying, whether your child is 6 weeks old or in the sixth grade, they're ready to learn how to practice empathy, compassion, and understanding. It's never too early to learn about diversity, equity, and inclusion. What's your reaction to that? 6 weeks old.
Well, empathy and understanding I have no objection to, but that's what the left has actually mastered, is using the veneer of friendly words, even diversity, equity, and inclusion, to cover up an agenda underneath it that is actually far more toxic in nature, that plants the seeds for this anti-excellence culture that begins at a young age. It is no longer cool to be number one in America. It is no longer appropriate to pursue excellence unabashedly. You have to apologize for it at every step of the way. And now we have this rampant culture in America where we can't pursue excellence and instead we elevate victimhood instead. Ultimately, you said the key words though, Carly. It is a business. This has become an industry. It is preying on our schools. It's a yeah. consulting industry. Look at the speaker fees of Robin DiAngelo and Abram Kendi. Yeah. It'll tell you all you need to know.
Yeah.
But I'm glad people are beginning to push back.
Yeah, and of course, kids don't see race. That's what makes them so beautiful and pure. They don't see color at all. Vivek Ramaswamy, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'm Steve Doocy.
I'm Brian Kilmeade.
And I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis.